tomorrow morning is going to be raining, and it's going to be exactly that way. You know what priest said? They just told them, this is spring, for God's sake. And spring, everybody knows, around summertime. And they just made a forecast, weather forecast, that is going to snow. I was just thinking in my heart, how could it ever be? But two nights ago, it snowed. How do they know? They've studied the weather. They know what brings snow, and it's going to snow. And it's not that they are reading the mind of God. They just read the signs of the time. And they will tell you we're going to have a Sunday spell. And it's going to be exactly that way. They know what regulates it. They know what happens. They are not the ones who regulate it. They know that when God allows a particular weather to come in, they know that another weather is coming after it. In the same way, there are things that happen and the glory of God come over your life. Nobody, if you have to wait for the glory of God to come, you will wait for the rest of your life and it will never come. You are the one who will initiate the glory of God over your life to come. And until the glory of God fills your life, don't expect that God will come. That is the harbinger of God. The glory of God is the harbinger of God. Okay? And when the glory of God is over a man or a woman's life, the person will know. Don't say, I didn't know that God is going to, there are so many things I know God is going to do in my life. I just know. That's why Paul got to a point. He got to a point about the hope in him. He said, Christ in us, the hope of glory. He was so convinced. He said, I am persuaded and I know that God is able to keep that which I've committed unto his hand against that. He knew, there's a knowing. He got to a point in Romans. He said, we have the Spirit of God in us that bears witness with our spirit that we are God's children. He said, the Spirit cries to God, Abba Father. He was connected. If you're connected, you will know. If you're not, you will also know. That's the way you ask people, are you born again? And they say, I don't know. He said, when did you get born again? I said, I don't know. You're not. If you don't know, you're not. That is what we call a source of salvation. It comes as a result. The glory of God begins to make the angels of God to interact with you. Because they are the one behind the glory of God. They are the one who release the glory of God. They begin to prepare you for the coming. They begin to prepare you for the manifestation. They begin to prepare you for what God could do. You begin to see series of things, and certain things drop off. You know they have dropped off. It's not a matter of just trying to say, I know God, you accept me anywhere I am, anyhow I am. He accepts you anyhow you are, the way you are, and he allows you to be who you are and stay how you are. He doesn't do anything about it, and he will give you judgment of how you are. He said, I am coming, my works are with me to give to everybody as their works have been. Every single person, the pastor, the evangelist, everybody in the church, your pastor doesn't stand for you. Your mom doesn't stand for you. You stand by yourself in front of God, whether it is given of reward here on earth or it is in heaven. Everybody will be rewarded according to their works have been. And you don't do stuff that you know are against God and you're expecting God to work in your favor. He won't. He will not. It doesn't matter how many people have anointed your head. He will not. It's a lie. All the things they have done to us in Africa, say, I don't care what you have done. I don't care what sin you have committed. I pray that my God will just open a new door for you. And the God will say, no, as far as this one is concerned, I'm not your God in this issue. You relate with me, I relate with you. You see, relate with me, I relate with that. That is why when God gave birth to you, you had your own eyes, your own mouth, your own mind. So nobody makes up your mind for you. Nobody takes your life to walk to a place. You're the one who does everything. And that is why you discover that God can have two people. Somebody can be a twin brother of another. And God comes to the twin brother and blesses him and lifts him. And the other twin brother is sitting down there and God is not doing anything with him. You see the case of Esau and Jacob. God bless one, God curse one. And that's the truth of life. God accept you the way he wants him to accept you. But there are people who will come to God and say no. Like David said, God, we have not seen our sign. There's a sign that I need to see. There's a sign of reason. Pastor Sade began to talk to me, he said, Pastor, you just think I'm up there, whatever, but I need some time to be able to do some few things. You know yourself. The Bible says, you examine yourself, whether you are in faith or not, except you be reprobate. Reprobate means a pastor. You know the level you are. You know whether God can break through or is a lie. Every person can be thinking your son, and you know inside your heart, God is saying, I'm gonna crucify you. I am gonna crucify you. You know, this Christianity is exclusively about personal relationship with God, and you cannot actually measure the level you have.
That's true.
It doesn't matter how many people come around you and try to comfort you in sin, try to comfort you in ungodliness. You know what you have done, you know who you are, and you know how God is going to come to you if you want to come. That is why when some people say, behold, he comes, I ask them, can you wait when he appears? If God appears in this place, can you wait? The children of Israel told Moses, you go, because he's been circumcised, the fire has consumed everything in his life. He said, you go, let this God speak to you. He thunders, lightens everything, and Moses could still walk into it. Somebody is listening to me. Somebody will say, God is so fearful and say, he's my father. I'm walking inside there. All of people say, pastors are now always frowns her face and whatever. People will say, my mommy is not a tiger. And if the mommy asks her anything, I say, why don't you put please? If you see, talk to the mom like that, and sometimes when I'm just there, she doesn't know what I'm getting. I just look. Anything the matter will do, that is what she will change because I'm looking. But under the circumstances, he commands her what to do. Just as I say, why are you frowning your face? Can't you laugh? She'll be asking her. And that is why some people are so far from God. They say, he's terrible God, he's this and that. And some people say, no, that is my father. The reason why you are saying he's terrible is because you are terrible. Because for the terrible, our God is terrible. For the froward, our God is froward. To the liar, he will make himself a deceiver to you. God is to you who you want him to be to you. If you want him to be true, you know, all of you, after you have done all the evil things you have done, you say, God, I know you forgive me. I know you are my God. I mean, you would, in your heart, you'll be hearing something, you'll be saying, yes, you are my daughter. But who really has to say, God, the one in heaven, Almighty, what can I do to come out of this? When God starts revealing stuff to you, you will cry. You will cry. You will cry. You say, God, I've degenerated so much. Help me and die. You just heap up pastors around yourself, heap up teachers, heap up people you can easily call when you have done evil. And you call them in Nigeria, you call them all over the world, and they start praying for you. Who don't know what you have done? And you send money to them, they will spend the money. And your sin has not been forgiven. They will use the car, send it to Nigeria. Send it to Zimbabwe. They will drive the car. Your sin has not been forgiven. God is not going to visit you because nobody can bribe you. You can bribe human beings. You cannot bribe the Almighty. That is why we're telling you, get into personal relationship. It's not about one pastor making noise on you. It's about you and the day you will need him.
Yeah, right on.
Chapter 40 of Isaiah. The day you will need him, that one pastor can come around. Let me tell you this. When a woman is pregnant, if it ought to be in Africa, you don't go with your wife to the labor room, you go and sleep. You are the big boss. You don't go. Maybe some people who have lived abroad before and they have asked them to go to with their wife to the labor room. Maybe if they return to Africa, they can go with their wife. But I just see wife, as they say, how are you guys? Everything, just kiss her. But here, they will ask you to come and stand with your wife. So you will have to actually go with your wife to the labor room. But that is as far as you can go. You can't bear the pain with her. You can't push for her. You are not going to deliver the baby for her. It is her own cup of tea, either hot or cold. So your life is a personal issue with God. Your life is what?
Personal issue.
And look at it, chapter 40. And the Bible says from verse 3. The voice of him crying in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be exalted, every mountain and hill shall be made low, cannot be eaten, all flesh, including your own seed. And there is no single person in this life who carries the glory of God who don't know. It's too heavy for you not to know. It's like you're wearing, you know, iron coat, iron jacket. How will you not know? You want to drag your feet, you discover that it can't be dragged along the normal way. You just know. But the scripture tells us here that four things have to go for the glory of God to be revealed. And don't pamper yourself, don't cover up yourself. If they are in there, eject them out if you really need God. And look at it from verse 4. Every valley. Valley means somewhere that you keep filling up and it's still down. You keep filling up. There are some holes in your life that when you pray to God, God wants to come in, there's a hole God enters into that your life that never gets filled up. And you have to fill the hole with body filler. By yourself. And it goes on to say, every mountain and hills shall be made low. That's pride. You're so proud there's nobody that can talk to you. Uncorrectable. Nobody can instruct you. Nobody can improve you. Every message they preach in the church is against you. Yes, there is something in your life. When it touches you, it is because there is something. Now, have you noticed when you go to the doctor, you say, I'm having pain. And the doctor wants to check you. The doctor begins to take his arm all over your body and he's touching it. You are even thinking of another thing as he's touching it. He's just touching it. When he touches the place that really pains you, he says, hey! He said, that is it. He said, he now press it inside. He said, how does it pain? Hey! He knows what to see. He will tell you whether it is appendicitis or typhoid fever. It's paining you because there is something there. When they preach in the church, it pains you. There is something. When they preach against 419, if you are not a 419, you won't be hungry. When they preach against adultery, if you are not an adulterer or adulteress, you won't be hungry. When they preach against lie, if you are not a liar, you won't be hungry. Why can't you come clean? One day I just say, I'm tired. Can't you be tired? Sometimes you say, I'm tired of potato. Can't you be tired of lie? I'm tired of adultery. I just say, I am tired. I've seen people like that. They just say, I'm just tired. Just take my life. What can you use, brother? I'm tired of all this shit. I don't want. And that is what God is talking about. And it goes on to say, every crooked place has been made straight. You're crooked, twisted, double tongued. What A hears is not what B hears. Must be made straight. Tongue must not be like the dead, must not be like the snake. Oh, snake has two tongues. One for this, that is why he was able to deceive Eve. He first of all came to Eve and said, oh, you're so beautiful. Does your husband take care of you nice? Oh no, there's a cream you can rub in this place. You'll be more beautiful. And Eve must say, as if you know, Adam is not always around, he's always busy with his wife. And then he said, oh, have you ever used aloe vera? And he said, no, I don't have money. He said, it's free. Do you think the discussion between Eve and snake was a straight discussion? The devil has never done straight discussion. Go to the book of Proverbs. The Bible says, when the prostitute wanted to get a man, he said, the Bible says, with sweet words, she comforts him and tells him, my husband is not at home. He has gone to war. I have perfumed my bed. Before the man will say, hey, perfume on the bed. He says, it's Egypt perfume, aloe vera. Say, with sweet words, the man was going to work before. The woman met him. The man forget about his work. And where would the woman go there?